Hi there, welcome to this video. Today we are going to talk about thermoelectric effect. Thermoelectric effect is the direct conversion of electrical voltage from a temperature difference between two surfaces or vice versa using a device called a thermocouple. A basic thermocouple is made up of two wires made from different materials. In my case, I used a wire of iron and then a wire of copper, which are twisted together at their extreme ends to form junctions. Then the copper wire is chopped in between to put a provision for connecting our electrical load. I am using an LED, which is a form of a bulb. When one junction is placed in a cold environment, let's say cold water, and then the other junction is placed in a hot environment, let's say hot water, then electricity is generated, which starts to flow through the LED, making it to light. This process is known as Seebeck effect. The electrical voltage generated is directly proportional to the temperature difference between the hot and the cold junction, which means that the more hot this junction is and the more cold this junction is, it creates a greater temperature difference, which also creates a greater voltage being generated. However, if you remove the LED or the bulb and then replace it with the battery, as you can see in this illustration, electrical energy will flow to these junctions, whereby it will cause one junction to be cold and then the other to be hot. And the temperature difference between the cold and hot junctions will be determined by how much voltage is coming from the battery. Meaning, when you increase the battery voltage, it will lead to a higher temperature difference. Meaning, the cold junction will become more cold, whereas the hot junction will become more hot. This entire process is known as Peltier effect. This kind of setup is used to make portable handheld refrigerators, like those ones which are used to carry vaccines to the remotest parts of the world, or a heater that can be used to warm up some surface. Now, the thermocouple that I'm using for illustration is just basic. If I get one junction of it and I put it in a hot environment and then the other junction in a colder environment, the maximum voltage I can ever get is around 1 millivolt. This means I'll need 1,000 of these thermocouples connected in series just for them to give me 1 volt. When it comes to powering the LED, which requires 2.5 volts to start lighting, it means that I will need 2,500 thermocouples connected in a series for them to be able to give me 2.5 volts, which will be able to power only one LED. This is like filling up the entire floor with thermocouples just to light an LED. That's why they are commercially available thermocouple modules that are made with hundreds of thermocouples, which are made from semiconductor materials such as silicon germanium and then sandwiched between two surfaces, whereby all the thermocouples that are inside are connected in series one after the other, whereby the hot junctions are put on one side and the cold junctions are put on the other side. These kind of thermocouple modules can be used as generators to produce electricity when one surface is put in a cold environment and then the other surface put in hot environment. They can also be used as coolers or heaters if you connect their terminals to the battery, whereby one surface will become cold and then the other will become hot. Therefore, the purpose of making this video is to see how we can quickly generate electricity using water of different temperatures and thermocouple modules. Before I can use a thermocouple module to generate electricity, let me show you how it can be used for cooling and heating. First of all, when I measure its surface temperatures on both of its sides, you see that they all have the same temperature of around 27 degrees Celsius. But when I get a battery and I connect it to the terminals for some few seconds, and then after I get a digital thermometer, you'll find that one surface will register 40 degrees Celsius while the other surface will register 30 degrees Celsius. So you can see that one side becomes colder and can be used for cooling stuff, whereas the other side becomes hot and can be used for heating stuffs. Well, continuing with our objective of generating electricity using a thermocouple module, I had to first create a setup that will provide two temperatures on the surfaces of the thermocouple module. This, I used a back box for an electric socket, a solder tape, and of course the thermocouple module itself. As you know that the back box for an electric socket is made with holes which serve a purpose for its intended use. But in our case, if we are to use it for our project, we have to cover those holes. And in my case, I use the solder tape so that we prevent any form of water leakage while it's being used. To generate enough electrical energy for this demonstration, I used a pair of socket back boxes and two pairs of thermocouple modules. Each pair of thermocouple modules is wrapped tightly together using solder tape so that they are fixed tightly and will be used to partition each socket back box into two. So at this moment, I got each pair of thermocouple modules and I inserted it into the socket back box. I made sure that the positioning of the thermocouple modules is just in the middle to create two equal partitions. Then I used hot glue to seal the contact surface so that it prevents leakage and possible mixture of water at different temperatures. To give identity of each partitioning of the electrical back box, I got a masking tape and a pen, wrote on it, and then tore that piece and stuck it into the partitioning. Please remember this, that the surface of the thermocouple module which has got writings on it is the same surface which should always subject to the cold conditions, and that surface without writings should be subjected to the hot conditions. This is the proper procedure of using the thermocouple modules, as it is clearly stated in their data sheet, if you want them to give you proper results while using them and on top of not getting damaged. Since I'm using four thermocouple modules, then I've got to join them electrically in series. This is done by joining the positive red wire of one module to the negative black wire of the next module using solder for each socket back box and then for both back boxes. This will give us one overall output voltage from all the four thermocouples, which is fed to the breadboard and to which other components are going to be connected to find this generated voltage. Those components include the multimeter, which is going to be used to indicate to us the amount of the generated voltage reaching other connected components, such as the lighting diode, known as an LED, the running motor, or a USB port for connecting a USB cable to charge a mobile phone. Now, to produce a cold environment for the thermocouple modules, I used some blocks of ice which I chopped into small pieces before carefully putting them into the cold partitioning of the socket back boxes. I then added some cold water to the ice pieces in order to increase their surface area touching the thermocouple modules. Then lastly, I pour hot water into the other chamber of the socket back box, and as you can see that immediately the LED starts to light as a result of electrical voltage being generated from the thermocouple modules. The generated voltage is around 6.6 volts, which is greater than 5 volts required by phones to charge. So we need to wait for temperature difference to reduce and then cause the voltage to drop to around 5 volts and then connect our USB cable to the port and then start our phone to charge. As you can see that when you connect the USB cable and check on the phone charging status, it shows you that it is indeed in a steady charging progress. Before we continue, let me show you a hand washing device that I redesigned to be smart, automatic, and touchless while delivering water and soap onto your hands. It has got other purposeful functions on top of being powered by a rechargeable battery that can last up to 5 days on a single charge. This device is good for your office, restaurant, hospital, home, school, and many other places. If you need this device, please contact us. When I replace a charging phone with a motor and I pour hot water into the hot chamber of the electrical socket back box, you see that immediately voltage starts to be generated, which keeps on rising, prompting the motor to start running, and its speed increases as I continue pouring more hot water. As you can notice, when I stop pouring the hot water, voltage immediately starts to drop. This is true because the cold ice starts absorbing some heat from the hot water and from the environment, and the hot water starts absorbing some coldness from the ice and from the environment. Now, that causes temperature difference between the two to drop, which results in less voltage being generated. Most of all, I thank you for having endured to watch this video up to this point. You can send me your questions via the comments section, you can share to your friends or press the like button, and above all, you can subscribe to this YouTube channel of mine called Binge Inventions for future updates on upcoming videos. Binge Inventions wishes you well.